गुड इवनिंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम मिस वंदना पई। सी इन टुडेज लेक्चर ऑफ द कोर्स डिप्लोमा इन ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट वी विल बी सीइंग वाइवावोस, ओके, विच इज अ पार्ट ऑफ पेपर नंबर 3। Okay, see, in the last lecture we have cleared what is project report. Okay, so just we will have a review of it, and after that we will go through what is Viva Voce. Okay, see, whenever we consider the paper number 3, whenever we consider the paper number 3, which is entitled as Diploma in Human Resource Management Paper 3. Okay, it is subdivided into 3 parts. Yes, first one is case study. Is it? Second one is project report. And the third part is Viva Voce. Okay, bagha, Diploma in Human Resource Management हा पूर्ण कोर्स 300 मार्कांचा आहे। त्याच्यामध्ये 3 पेपर आहेत, प्रत्येक पेपरला वेटेज 100 मार्क्सचा एवढा आहे। ओके, पेपर नंबर 3 त्यातला प्रॅक्टिकल ओरिएंटेड आहे, पेपर नंबर 1 जो आहे तो 100 मार्क्सचा थेरॉटिकल पेपर आहे, ज्याचं टायटल मॅनेजमेंट ऑफ इंडस्ट्रियल रिलेशन्स असं आहे। पेपर नंबर 2 जो आहे तो कॉम्पेन्सेशन मॅनेजमेंट अँड एथिक्स असा आहे, तो सुद्धा 100 मार्क्सचा पेपर आहे, थेरॉटिकल पेपर आहे। आणि पेपर नंबर 3, ओके, जसं की मगाशी मी सांगितलं, प्रॅक्टिकल ओरिएंटेड पेपर आहे, ओके, तो सुद्धा 100 मार्क्सचा पेपर आहे। सो व्हेनेव्हर वी कन्सिडर whenever we consider this paper number 3, yes, the paper number 3 is classified into 3 parts. Okay, which are these 3 parts? First part is, yes, case study. Okay, second part is project report, and the third part is Viva Voce. So, when we consider the paper number 3 itself, okay, we get an idea that, yes, when we consider the paper number 3, we get an idea that, okay, overall, your paper number 3 is practical oriented, is it? See, the first part for 30 marks we have already studied, that is case study. Okay, what is case study? Yes, till now we have gone through many of the case studies, is it? Case study means what? See, you will be given an issue. You will be given an issue related to any organization. Yes, you will be given an issue related to any organization, is it? So what we were required to do there? Yes, that issue related to organization we were supposed to sort it out. Okay, we were supposed to sort it out. Isn't it? Means, okay, what we were supposed to do? Yes, we were supposed to handle the issues or problems. See, considering you as a human resource officer or a human resource manager, okay, a situation of any organization, it was given to you. Okay, and what we were supposed to do? Yes, you were supposed to carefully read the situation, understand it, okay, and beneath those cases, okay, some questions were asked which were personalized in nature. Okay, the questions were personalized in nature. Means what? Okay, see, whenever we consider such type of cases, what we are supposed to do? Yes, we were supposed to carefully read that case, is it? Then summarize it, have a gist of that case, okay? Based on that, okay, you were supposed to be or perform the role of human resource manager, okay, with the rational mindset, okay, you were supposed to give some solutions, okay, the solutions to be given in such a way that, okay, it will be benefiting the organization without hurting the emotions or related interests of any of them, okay, without hurting the interest of anyone. Okay, what you are supposed to do? You are supposed to sort the case out. Okay, getting it? Yes, the viva voce. Okay, this is also part of your paper number 3. Okay, the case study is the weightage given to the case study is 30 marks. Okay, the project report, it is for 40 marks, and the viva voce, that is the oral, which is based on the project report, it is for 30 marks. बघा पेपर नंबर 3 चा जेव्हा आपण विचार करतो तेव्हा ओके पेपर नंबर 3 चा क्लासिफिकेशन 3 प्रकारे केले जातं. ओके, कोणते प्रकार आहेत ते 3? यस, केस स्टडी, प्रोजेक्ट रिपोर्ट आणि वायवा वोस. ओके, आता जेव्हा आपण केस स्टडीचा विचार करतो तेव्हा केस स्टडी काय आहे बघा. आतापर्यंत बऱ्याचशा केस स्टडीज आपण सॉल्व केलेले आहेत, बरोबर आहे. काय असतात केस स्टडीज? येस, एखाद्या ऑर्गनायझेशनची एखादी सिच्युएशन किंवा एखादा इश्यू तुमच्यासमोर डिस्क्लोज केला जातो, बरोबर आहे. ओके, आणि काय करायचं मग? ती केस जी असेल किंवा ते जे प्रॉब्लेम आपल्याला किंवा ते जे तो जो इश्यू आपल्यासमोर डिस्क्लोज केलेला आहे, ओके, तो थोरली आपल्याला वाचायचा आहे. ओके, त्याच्यावरून त्याची जी जीस्ट आहे ती समराईज करायची, त्याच्यावरती जी जीस्ट आहे ती समराईज करायची. आणि मग काय करायचं? बघा, तिथे आपण रॅशनल माइंडसेटने आपण HR मॅनेजर आहोत असे इमॅजिन करायचे. आणि मग काय करायचं? ओके, त्याच्याखालती जे क्वेश्चन्स दिले जातील ते थरोली रीड करायचेत. ओके, क्वेश्चन्स रीड करायचेत आणि मग काय करायचं? ओके, त्याचं सोल्युशन असे त्या क्वेश्चन्सवरती जे सोल्युशन्स मागितलेत आपल्याला विचारले गेलेत, ओके, ते सोल्युशन्स आपण द्यायचेत. हे म्हणजे केस स्टडी. ओके, आणि केस स्टडीचा एक ॲडव्हान्टेज बघा, आन्सर्स पर्सनलाइज असतात. ओके, सो इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी विल बी फोकसिंग ऑन प्रोजेक्ट रिपोर्ट अँड वायवा वोस. ओके, सी इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हॅव गॉन थ्रू प्रोजेक्ट रिपोर्ट. ओके, अ ब्रीफ रिव्ह्यू ऑफ वॉट इज प्रोजेक्ट रिपोर्ट. ओके, सी वेन एवर वी कन्सिडर प्रोजेक्ट रिपोर्ट, ओके, द वेटेज फॉर प्रोजेक्ट रिपोर्ट इज 40 मार्क्स. ओके, प्रोजेक्ट रिपोर्ट जे आहे त्याचं वेटेज किती आहे? तर 40 मार्क्स एवढं आहे. ओके, याच्यामध्ये बघा, एक तुम्हाला डिझाईन दिलेली आहे, प्रोजेक्ट रिपोर्टची एक डिझाईन दिलेली आहे. ह्या डिझाईनला तुम्ही फॉलो करायचं आहे. ओके, काय डिझाईन आहे बघा, इंट्रोडक्शन टू द टॉपिक, कन्सेप्च्युअल नॉलेज, प्रोफाईल ऑफ द कंपनी, ऑब्जेक्टिव्ज ऑफ द स्टडी, हायपोथेसिस ऑफ द स्टडी, सिग्निफिकन्स ऑफ द स्टडी, फाइंडिंग्स अँड कन्क्ल्युजन. ओके, बघा, तुमचं प्रोजेक्टचं जे डिझाईन असेल, ओके, प्रोजेक्टचं जे डिझाईन असेल त्याचं प्रोजेक्टचं जे लेआउट असेल त्या लेआउटमध्ये तुम्हाला हे 8 पॉईंट्स कन्सिडर करायचे आहेत. कोणकोणते? फर्स्ट, येस, वेन एवर वी कन्सिडर युअर प्रोजेक्ट रिपोर्ट विच इज फॉर 40 मार्क्स, यू आर सपोज टू इन्क्लूड ऑल दिस 8 पॉईंट्स. ओके, मीन्स द लेआउट ऑफ युअर प्रोजेक्ट, द लेआउट ऑफ युअर प्रोजेक्ट इट शुड बी कम्प्राइजिंग ऑफ ऑल दिस 8 पॉईंट्स. ओके, फर्स्ट वॉट यू आर सपोज टू डू, यू आर सपोज टू इंट्रोड्यूस द टॉपिक. ओके, सी सम ऑफ द टायटल्स विच वी हॅव डिस्कस्ड इन टू द लास्ट लेक्चर दे वेअर अ स्टडी ऑन द वेरियस एम्प्लॉई वेलफेअर स्कीम ॲट कंपनी. ओके, HR policies and implementation at BPO. Then, employee retention strategies at --- company. A report on recruitment and selection. A report on training methods at --- company. Is it? See, these were the 5 titles which we have discussed with you. Okay, which we have discussed. Okay, see, what you are required to do here, you are required to follow the layout strictly. You are required to follow the layout strictly. Means what? For example, if you have considered the first title, that is a study on various employee welfare schemes at --- company. Okay, what is included in this? Study on the various employee welfare schemes at dash dash company. Yes, first we need to introduce this topic, what this title is. ओके बघा पहिल्या पॉईंटमध्ये काय गरजेचं आहे की तुम्हाला ते टायटल जे आहे ते इंट्रोड्यूस करायचं आहे. म्हणजे अ स्टडी ऑन द व्हेरियस एम्प्लॉई वेलफेअर स्कीम्स. ओके म्हणजे काय, ओके हे तुम्हाला तिथे एलॉबरेट करायचं आहे, ते तुम्हाला ओके डिटेलमध्ये तिथे सांगणं गरजेचं आहे. ओके देन द सेकंड थिंग, HR पॉलिसीज and implementation of BPO. Okay, when we consider the point number one, introduction to the topic. Okay, introduction to the topic. Okay, what we are required to do here? Yes, what do you mean by HR policies and implementation at BPO? Then, in the third topic, employee retention strategies at dash dash company. Okay, here what we are supposed to do? How the retention strategies of employee, they are adopted in different companies. Okay, whatsoever or whichever company you have identified. Okay, related to that, what you are required to do? Yes, you are required to quote out the employee retention strategies. Then a report on recruitment and selection. Okay, means what is the recruitment and selection procedure? Adopted in different companies, okay, whichever company you have highlighted, what is the recruitment and selection procedure? Okay, you are supposed to introduce this. Then a report on training methods at dash dash company. Okay, what you are required to do? Yes, what are the different training methods adopted across the industries? Okay, you are required to mention this. Okay, so whenever we consider the first point which you will be including, okay, the first point which you will be including in the first point which you will be including into your project report, that is introduction to the topic. Here what you are required to do, whatsoever title which you highlight, you are supposed to introduce that title. The second point which we will be covering into your project report for 40 marks is conceptual knowledge. Okay, conceptual knowledge. See, once again we will move towards the project titles. Okay, What is it? See, in the first title, what we are required to do? Yes, various employee welfare schemes. Is it? Various employee welfare schemes. Means what? Okay, whenever we consider various employee welfare scheme, what does it means? Yes, we are required to keep that in mind. Okay, then HR policies and implementation at BPO. What do you mean by HR policies? Okay. Then employee retention strategies. What do you mean by employee retention strategies? Okay. Then recruitment and selection. Okay, what are these two terms, recruitment and selection? What it means? Then training methods. What are the different training methods? Okay, so whenever we go through all these five titles, okay, the concepts which are included in these titles, that means, okay, the concept on which you will be focusing, the concept on which you will be focusing, is it? The concept on which you will be focusing, those things, okay, those things, they will be, yes, your conceptual knowledge or conceptual framework. Means the concept on which you will be highlighting, the concept on which you will be highlighting, those concepts you are required to elaborate in the second point. Okay, then profile of the company. Okay, profile of the company. What do you mean by profile of the company? See, in this five titles, whichever you will be selecting, okay, one of the title among the five titles, whichever you will be selecting. Okay, what you are required to do? Yes, you are required to, okay, highlight a company, any company, okay, maybe multinational company or any ordinary company, okay, in which HR practices they are prevailing. Okay, what you are required to do there? Yes, profile of the company means, okay, the information related to the company. For example, what is the history of company? When the company was established? Where is the head office or headquarter of that company? How many branches they are run by this company? Okay. Then, what are the different products of that company? Okay. So, whenever we go through such type of companies, okay, in profile of company, what you are required to do? You are required to mention all the necessary things related to that company. Okay, that is information related to company itself will be the profile of company. Okay, then objectives of the study. Okay, objectives of the study. Okay, so once again we will move towards the project titles. Okay, so objective of study of all these five titles, we will first discuss it, okay, so that it will be easier for us to highlight what are the objectives. Objectives means why you are doing study, why you are doing this present study. See, the objective related to the first number title, that is a study on the various employee welfare schemes at XYZ company. What might be the objectives of the study? Yes. The objectives of this study might be to study the various employee welfare scheme at XYZ company. Okay, XYZ company here means, okay, the company which you will be selecting. Okay, the company which you will be selecting, okay, that itself will be that XYZ company. Okay, getting it? Then, the second objective related to the project title number one, it will be to study the impact of employee welfare scheme, okay, to study the impact of employee welfare scheme on employee performance. This can be your second objective, isn't it? Okay. The third objective might be to study the relationship between employee welfare scheme and organization's productivity or performance. Okay, so when we consider the project title number one, this can be the objectives. Okay, there can be many more objectives related to this. Okay. Then the project title number two, HR policies and implementation at BPO. HR policies and implementation at BPO. See, what might be the objectives of your title number second, project title number second, which is HR policies and implementation at BPO. Yes, it might be to study the various HR policies and implementation of those HR policy in so and so company. This might be your one of the objectives. The second objective might be to study the impact of HR policies on performance of employees. Third title might be to study, to study the relation between HR policies, implementation and BPO working. Okay, this might be the objectives related to the study or project title number second. Then, employee retention strategies at dash and dash company. What is it? See, what might be the objectives of this study? The objective might be to study the employee retention strategies at XYZ company. Yes, to study the relationship between employee retention strategy and the individual performance of that employee. Okay. This can be the objectives related to project number third title. Fourth, a report on recruitment and selection. What might be the objective? Yes, to study the recruitment and selection procedure in so and so company. Yes, to study. Okay. The relationship between recruitment and selection procedure and the job satisfaction. Okay, this can be your second objective. Then a report on training methods at so and so company. This can be okay, a study on training methods of so and so company. Is it a study on training methods and impact on knowledge development of performance of the employee? This can be your one of the objectives. Is it? Then hypothesis of the study. Here you are supposed to do assumptions related to it, to study the relationship. Is it? Based on your objectives. Based on your objectives of the study, you are required to frame up the hypothesis. You are required to frame up the hypothesis. Okay. For example, there is a positive impact of employee welfare scheme on performance of employee. This can be one of your hypothesis. Okay. Likewise, based on the project title, you are supposed to write down at least two hypotheses. Okay. Then significance of the study. Significance of the study. What it means? Significance of the study means why the study is so important. Is it? Why to study employee welfare schemes? Why to study HR policies? Is it? This importance you are supposed to write here. Then the findings. Okay, after you did study, what did you find? What did you found actually? Then the conclusion, that is you are supposed to summarize your study into 2 to 3 sentences. Okay. After your project report, you are supposed to give oral on it. That is viva voce for 30 marks. Okay. So what is viva voce? Yes, viva voce means that. Yes, you are supposed to give a oral based on your project report. Viva voce manje kay ki project jo tumhi kelela aahe 40 markancha tyachyavarti adharit tumhala ek oral dyaychi aahe jyachyamadhye bareche points tumhala cover karayche je tumcha screen varti disatat. Okay, kon konte points ahet baka. Okay, first. Okay, whenever you are giving viva, okay, first, whenever you are giving viva, what you are supposed to do? Yes. You are supposed to introduce yourself. Means, you are supposed to give your introduction. You are supposed to give your introduction. Okay. Then, okay, in your introduction, what are the things which you are supposed to note down? Yes, first, yes, you are supposed to greet. What you are supposed to do? You are supposed to greet. For example, good morning, good afternoon, is it? Based on the time, is it? What you are supposed to do first? Yes, you are supposed to introduce yourself. For example, I am so and so. Is it first? You will say good morning. And after that, you will be saying, yes, I am so and so. I am from. Is it? I have completed so and so degree. I have completed so and so course. Is it? Or I have completed HSC with so and so percentile. Is it? Such type of introduction you are supposed to do. Is it? Then you are supposed to, yes, say something about your interest areas. That is, I am interested in, or I have interest in, for example, your hobbies. For example, playing cricket. Okay, I am interested in playing cricket. I am interested in reading books. Is it? Such kind of thing you are supposed to mention and introduce yourself. Okay, then introduce the title. Yes, you are supposed to introduce the title. Means what? Introduce the title. Means what? Yes, the title whichever you have selected. Okay, you are supposed to introduce it. Means here, you are supposed to elaborate the title of the study. You are supposed to elaborate the title of your study. Is it? Then, reason for selection of topic. Reason for selection of the topic. Means what? Why you have selected the topic, particular topic? Yes, the significance of selection of the topic. Okay, you are supposed to elaborate here. Then, you are supposed to say something about the significance of the study. Means, why this study is so important. Okay, why this study is so important, you are supposed to mention it. Then, the objectives of study, you are supposed to, yes, discuss the objectives of the study, whichever you have mentioned into your project report. Okay, je tumcha project report madhe mention kelele ahet, te objectives tumhi the sangayche ahet. Then, what are the findings of your study? Yes, you are supposed to mention the findings of your study. Then, you are supposed to mention the conclusion and summary of your project. Yes, summary of your project and conclusion of your project. Okay, you are supposed to note it down. बघा जेव्हा आपण वायवा वोस याचा विचार करतो तेव्हा हे 8 पॉइंट्स तुम्हाला त्याच्यामध्ये क्लियर करावे लागतील. ओके, वायवा वोस म्हणजे काय? वायवा वोस म्हणजे एक ओरल एग्जामिनेशन्स. ओके, एक ओरल एग्जामिनेशन जी की प्रोजेक्ट रिपोर्टवरती आधारित आहे. ओके, तुम्हाला काय करायचं इथे? पहिल्यांदा तुम्हाला तुमचं सेल्फ इंट्रोडक्शन द्यायचं आहे. येस, सेल्फ इंट्रोडक्शनमध्ये सुद्धा बरेचसे पॉईंट्स आहेत. बघा, तुम्हाला पहिल्यांदा ग्रीट करावं लागेल, दॅट इज गुड मॉर्निंग, गुड आफ्टरनून वगैरे. इज इट? त्याच्यानंतर तुम्ही तुमचं नाव मेन्शन करायचं आहे, फुल नेम, तुमचं लोकेशन दॅट इज रेसिडेन्स मेन्शन करायचं आहे, तुम्ही एच एस सी किती मार्कांनी पास झालेला आहात ते मेन्शन करायचं आहे. त्याच्यानंतर ओके, तुम्हाला इथे तुमचे इंटरेस्ट एरिया सांगायचं आहे. ओके, तुमचे अदर अचीवमेंट्स काय असतील तर तेही तुम्ही तिथे मेन्शन करू शकता. ओके, त्याच्यानंतर तुम्हाला टायटल इंट्रोड्यूस करायचं आहे, म्हणजे जो की तुमचा प्रोजेक्ट टायटल आहे, जे ही तुमचं प्रोजेक्ट टायटल आहे त्या प्रोजेक्ट टायटल तुम्हाला इंट्रोड्यूस करायचं आहे. ओके, तुमचं प्रोजेक्ट टायटल जे आहे ते इंट्रोड्यूस करायचं आहे. ओके, त्याच्यानंतर रिझन फॉर सिलेक्शन ऑफ टॉपिक. ओके, रिझन फॉर सिलेक्शन ऑफ टॉपिक. ओके, इथे तुम्हाला स्टेटमेंट ऑफ प्रॉब्लेम काय होता आणि तो स्टडी करणं काय इम्पॉर्टंट होता हे तुम्हाला मेन्शन करायचं आहे. ओके, देन सिग्निफिकन्स ऑफ द स्टडी. सिग्निफिकन्स ऑफ स्टडीमध्ये काय करायचं आहे, ओके, का स्टडी एवढा इम्पॉर्टंट आहे हे तुम्हाला तिथे मेन्शन करायचं आहे. ओके, त्याच्यानंतर ऑब्जेक्टिव्ज ऑफ द स्टडी. ओके, म्हणजे कोणकोणते ऑब्जेक्टिव्ज आहेत ह्या स्टडीमागे, इज इट, ते तुम्हाला इथे मेन्शन करायचं आहे. त्याच्यानंतर फाइंडिंग्स ऑफ द स्टडी. ओके, फाइंडिंग्स ऑफ द स्टडी मीन्स व्हॉट. ओके, हे स्टडी जे केलेलं आहे तुम्ही त्याच्यावरती इज इट फाइंडिंग्स काय तुम्हाला फाउंड झाली. ओके, ते तुम्हाला तिथे मेन्शन करायचं आहे. ओके, त्याच्यानंतर कन्क्लुजन अँड समरी, जे की तुम्ही तुमच्या प्रोजेक्टमध्ये सांगितलेलं आहे. ओके, तेच तुम्हाला इथे सांगायचं आहे. सो हे 8 पॉईंट्स तुमच्या वायवा वोसमध्ये असले पाहिजेत.